Welcome aboard Alex's Animal Ark. My name is Alex and I will be your guide to all the amazing animals that live on our planet. Today we will be learning about the roseate spoonbill. So what exactly is a roseate spoonbill? To start with, they're the only species of spoonbill native to the Western Hemisphere. They are a very large wading bird. They can reach lengths of 28 to 34 inches and can weigh between 2.6 and 4 pounds. They can also reach a height of 2.5 feet. Their wingspan can reach up to 4 feet, and they live up to 10 years in the wild. Roseate spoonbills have a football-shaped body. This body is covered with bright pink plumage on their wings and the underside, with a red patch on their wings. They have a white neck and back with a pale green bald head and red eyes. Their most distinguishing feature is their spoon-shaped bill. This bill can reach lengths between 5.7 and 7.1 inches. They use it to scoop up the organisms they eat, which gives them their pink color. Their neck is very long, and they fly with it extended, unlike herons and other birds. They also have very long legs. So where do roseate spoonbills live? They mostly live in marsh-like areas and mangroves. They're found in South America east of the Andes Mountains. They're also found in coastal areas of the Caribbean, Central America, and Mexico. In the United States, they're found in the Gulf Coast and from Florida to about Myrtle Beach in South Carolina. So what are some roseate spoonbill behaviors? Well, roseate spoonbills are active during the day, but they mainly forage during the evenings. They primarily eat small fish, crustaceans, and invertebrates. They forage for their food by walking through shallow, muddy water with their bill partially open. Then when they find something, they will scoop it up with their bill and swallow it. Roseate spoonbills are very social. This means they like to roost, feed, and fly in formation with others. They like to nest as colonies made up of mated pairs. They typically nest in mangroves or on islands. They don't start breeding until their third year. During breeding season, the male brings the female nest-building materials. The female will then build a large platform with a deep hollow in the center, filled with twigs and leaves. This nest is typically 5 to 15 feet off the ground. The female will then lay a clutch of 1 to 5 eggs that are whitish with brown markings. The incubation takes 22 to 24 days, and both parents take turns sitting on the eggs to keep them warm. When the chicks are hatched, they are light pink with white fluff. The parents will feed the chicks by regurgitating food into the baby's bill. After a month, the chicks will start exercising by climbing around their nest and flapping their wings. By 6 weeks, the chicks have developed their flight feathers and are ready to leave the nest. And now it's time for some roseate spoonbill fun facts. Did you know they almost went extinct in the 1800s? Due to hunting for their pink plumage for use in the hats? Male and females present sticks to each other at the end of their first courtship. Did you know that baby spoonbills don't start out with a spoonbill? Roseate spoonbills lose their feathers on their heads as they get older. Did you know that one was spotted in Saline, Michigan in the Koch Warner Drain on July 20th, 2021? Officials either think it escaped from the local zoo or it's very lost. Thank you for listening. If you enjoyed it and want to hear more, feel free to subscribe to Alex's Animal Ark on YouTube or subscribe on Spotify, Deezer, Stitcher, TuneIn, Amazon Music, Apple Podcasts, Overcast, Castro, Castbox, Podfriend, and iHeartRadio. Thank you for coming on this animal adventure. I will see you all again for the next voyage.